Now, the last kicks of a dying horse and power play within Azimio between Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Odinga after a very bitter fallout.
As Azimio, we are together on this issue. You may hear people saying, but we are together. That kwamba, yale ambayo yanawahusu wa Kenya, haya kujadiliwa. Now, if you want to sum it all, listen to what D said.
So it turns out that the recent dialogue meeting, final report proposals by the National Dialogue Committee, is what will take the Azimio La Umoja One Kenya Alliance to the grave of the forgotten. This is after the split witnessed in Azimio as top officials Martha Karua, Uhuru Kenyatta and Eugene Wamalwa disputed the proposals, arguing that they failed to tackle the critical matters that Kenyans are currently facing. According to the National Dialogue Committee, led by the majority leader in the National Assembly, Honorable Kimani Ichungwa, and the Wiper Party leader, Dr. Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, after their 4 months long sitting, they failed to reach out to a consensus on the housing levy and the reduction of the VAT. Raila Odinga, from the other end, is walking under a very tight rope, trying to factor out whether to agree or disagree with the proposals, after he faced a lot of criticism from the hostile Azimio La Umoja Alliance supporters over betrayal. From Raila Odinga's official ODMX account, Raila Odinga ended up posting this particular statement here. Let me just read for you and show you on the screen. I will make my position on the report of the National Dialogue Committee this Thursday. So let us wait and see how things will turn out to be, and also the final decision that Raila Odinga will have to make. But in my considered opinion, I tend to think that Raila Odinga is very keen on waiting for further instructions from the Azimio patron Uhuru Kenyatta himself. But William Ruto welcomed the proposals, asserting that he will support the deliberation process. But in my considered opinion, ladies and gentlemen, the secret truth behind all these issues here and the fallout together with the betrayal within Azimio is currently here. The power play between Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Odinga in Azimio La Umoja Alliance. And that simply explains this particular article here. Let me just read for you. Divisions in Azimio as Uhuru Kenyatta, Martha Karua and Eugene Wamalwa distance themselves completely from Raila Odinga William Ruto talks. So you can clearly tell that Uhuru Kenyatta is on one side with Martha Karua and Eugene Wamalwa. Raila Odinga on the other side is with Dr. Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. So let us wait and see who exactly will win in this particular contest. But in this particular analysis here, ladies and gentlemen, I want us to mainly focus on Eugene Wamalwa officially pulling out of Raila Odinga for Uhuru Kenyatta and Martha Karua.
Na leo nikiwa nyumbani, nataka niseme haya, sababu simi niko nyumbani. Sendivu hocha. Hapa nikisema kuna mtu anatisha mimi kweli. Jana report ya Bomas imekamilika. Sikuweko kule Nairobi, lakini wenzangu wameweka sahihi. Report hiyo inaenda kwa Mheshimiwa Ruto na Mheshimiwa Raila Odinga. Baada ya hapo itaenda bungeni ili iweze kujadiliwa na wabunge wetu. So leo nikiwa hapa nyumbani Western, tumekuwa hapa juzi tukiwa Vihiga County, mimi nilikuwa nimesema ya kwamba mimi sitaweka sahihi huo mkataba. I said this in Vihiga, hapa Western. I said this in Mwingi, kule Eastern. I will not sign that agreement. Na leo nikiwa nyumbani, nimekuja nyumbani nikiwa na moyo mzito sana. Sababu ule mkataba umeweka sahihi, we as the representatives of the people of Kenya did not do justice.
As for me, I consider that as betrayal, considering the fact that, first of all, Eugene Wamalwa comes from the Western region. Western region is mainly ODM. So I tend to think that for Eugene Wamalwa to be on the safer side, he should be supporting Raila Amolo Odinga. But the question here still remains. Why do you think Eugene Wamalwa chose Uhuru Kenyatta and Martha Karua over Raila Odinga? I want to explain to you the critical details concerning all these issues. But before that, just a quick reminder that if you're watching me up to this point and you haven't subscribed to this channel, I'm requesting you to please take a second or two to please subscribe here. You can also give this particular video here a like. Just press the thumbs up button so that YouTube can automatically recommend this channel and this video to reach out to others. To my returning subscribers also, I really want to appreciate you for watching and listening, and basically for your continued support. Without your support, this channel cannot be where it is currently, and that is why I don't take the support for granted. You can also simply receive the notifications updates automatically from YouTube itself immediately I post a video on this channel by simply pressing the notification bell. Just activate the notification bell and you will receive the notifications from YouTube. Having said that, now let us go straight into the details. First of all, in my considered opinion, is this: Eugene Wamalwa as the former CS for defense. That particular position in the previous regime or the previous Jubilee administration, Uhuru Kenyatta was the one who appointed Eugene Wamalwa in that position. So therefore, it is very hard for Eugene Wamalwa to turn his back on Uhuru Kenyatta. He will always play loyalty to Uhuru Kenyatta simply because of him appointing Eugene Wamalwa to that particular position. Secondly, ladies and gentlemen, it is all about Eugene Wamalwa's next political move ahead of the 2027 general elections. Now, because politics is all about interest, what do you think Raila Odinga can offer to Eugene Wamalwa ahead of the 2027 general elections? In my considered opinion, Eugene Wamalwa must be on the side of Uhuru Kenyatta, because at least Uhuru Kenyatta has got no political interest ahead of the 2027 general elections. Therefore, he can offer his support to Eugene Wamalwa and Martha Karua. Raila Odinga, from the other side, has already made his own decision to support Dr. Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka ahead of the 2027 general elections. Therefore, he can offer absolutely nothing to Eugene Wamalwa. And finally, I also speculate about a bit of fallout between Eugene Wamalwa and Raila Odinga. And that simply explains as to why Eugene Wamalwa has not been attending Raila Odinga's very critical political events. When last did you see Eugene Wamalwa with Raila Odinga? So I speculate the bitter fallout between these two individuals. But let us wait and see how things will turn out to be. Otherwise, that is it, ladies and gentlemen. I don't have much. But the question here is, what can you say and what exactly do you think about Uhuru Kenyatta, Martha Karua and Eugene Wamalwa's political differences with Raila Odinga and Kalonzo Musyoka? Let me also know your thoughts, your views and your opinions on the comment section down below.